હેલો નમસ્તે શશ્રીયાકાલ કેમ છો મજામાં આઈ એમ ફેરિલ ફ્રોમ ફેરિલ સ્માર્ટ વર્લ્ડ એન્ડ આઈ એમ થ્રિલ બિકોઝ આઈ એમ એટ રાજદૂત ભવન આઈ એમ એટ ઇન્ડિયન એમ્બેસી ઓફ એડિસ અબાબા ઇથોપિયા એન્ડ ડુ યુ નો દેટ ઇન્ડિયન એમ્બેસી ઇઝ ઓલ્સો અ સેકન્ડ હોમ ફોર પીપલ હુ આર અવે ફ્રોમ યર કન્ટ્રી સો આઈ એમ એક્સાઇટેડ ટુ શો યુ હાઉ ધી ઇન્ડિયન એમ્બેસી લુક્સ કમ વિથ મી Hey guys, do you know it is such a privilege to be at Indian Embassy and make a short vlog. So let me just tell you a bit history about India and Ethiopia. The linkage between India and Ethiopia is like more than 2000 years, and there was the first Aksumite traders that actually visited India for spices and for silk. So after the India's independence, Sardar Sant Singh was sent to Ethiopia as a goodwill ambassador, or you can call it as an ambassador to Ethiopia. And Otto Emmanuel Abraham was the first ambassador of Ethiopia to India.
Okay. Namaskar. Tenastelin Dana Adrachu Mohan Lal Ibalalu. By Ethiopia, Yahind Embassy was Isaralo. Hulutanya Sahafi Naya. By Ethiopia, Kasost Amat. Balai Koichallu. Namaskar, this is Mohan Lal. I am second secretary in the Embassy of India. You are welcome to the video of our embassy. Thank you.
Hey guys, so right now I am at the Heritage House. This is the Heritage House. Before the first year, secretary of India used to live in this house, but now this has been a Heritage House. So basically, embassy is a base where it handles all the diplomatic mission. That means all political, social and cultural things are handled.
Yeah, my name is Hussain. Good morning. I'm second secretary in Embassy of India, Addis Ababa. I deal with the works related to culture and education. We closely work with Ethiopian authorities to enhance people-to-people connectivity between people of India and Ethiopia. Many cultural communities between India and Ethiopia, and we are making efforts to promote our cultural exchange. In the field of education, our relation began during the imperial times, and that still exists with a large number of Indian professors present in various universities of Ethiopia. Indian teachers enjoy a very good reputation, and their spectacular performance and services are fervently admired throughout Ethiopia. Every year, hundreds of Ethiopians go to India for pursuing various courses under ITEC and ICCR scholarship programs. So we try to keep this momentum to take our bilateral relation to a newer height. Thank you very much.
Namaste, my name is Balanesh Gosai. I'm working in the Embassy of India as a marketing assistant. I love India. India is a second home for me. I finished my first degree and second degree 20 years back, but still the memories are fresh. And I finished my first degree in Ferguson College, major in economics. The second one, I finished it in Pune University in master's in business administration. Even I traveled so many places in India, like a place, Goa, Bangalore, Mysore, Ooty, In the north, I visited Taj Mahal, Delhi, and I love India. It's a beautiful place. Thank you.
And do you know, guys, that Ethiopia is the first country from Africa to have its first embassy in India in New Delhi during 1950s?
My name is Akli Roku. I'm working at the Indian Embassy at Addis Ababa as an executive assistant. I was in India for studies in computer engineering, and the people in India are like, they are the best, they cooperate, and I never felt like I'm outside the country, my country. When I was in India, people are nice, cooperative. I never felt like I was not at home at all. The people are very good, and they are the best.
So guys, do you know that there has been bilateral visit between India and Ethiopia? Like, Ethiopia's Prime Minister Meles Zenawi had been in India, and India's President S. Radhakrishnan, our Prime Minister Mr. Manmohan Singh, President Mr. Ramnath Kovind had been in Ethiopia.
My name is Laka, Laka Olde. I'm working in the Indian Embassy for last many years, and I got a chance to visit Mumbai, and I like India very much. I love India, and I like their foods and their cultures and everything. I love India. Thank you.
Do you know that India has established a vocational training cum incubation center in Ethiopia under Indian African Forum Summit? And the purpose of the center is to provide training in 20 types of manufacturing trade like soy milk, bakery, tomato ketchup, fruit juices, edible oil, gemstone cutting, polishing, paper napkin, and so on. Hey, good morning, friends. It's such a great opportunity for me. I'm at India House, that is the ambassador's house. And it's an opportunity for me because I will have a quick question answer session with him. So let's get started. And yeah, before we get started, I just have to tell you that this is the house which has been constructed recently. He has moved to this new place, new residence, just few months back. And I will show you the glimpse of his house. Hey, good morning, friends. I'm so excited and enthralled because I'm at India House. India House is a residence of the ambassador, and right now I'm with Mr. Robert Chikingtong, and he is the ambassador of India to Ethiopia. So let's talk to him. So Mr. Robert Chikingtong, how are you this morning?
Very fine, thank you.
So Mr. Robert, this is your first post in Ethiopia. So how is Ethiopia treating you, and what are your future plans for the Indian community? Can you please tell us?
This is my first ambassadorial assignment for me. As a career diplomat, having the opportunity to serve in Ethiopia is a great opportunity. Ethiopia and India have excellent, multifaceted, and strong relationship. It encompasses political aspects where we have excellent relations. Leaders from Ethiopia, leaders from India have visited its country. The last visit from India was our Honorable President in 2017. I think today our bilateral relations have reached that state where it is so diverse. When it comes to business and economics, you will find that there are so many Indian companies. Indian investment today is the second largest in this country. There are more than 600 Indian companies here, giving employment to more than 70,000 Ethiopians. Even in culture, even in science and technology, even in the aspects of defense, our relations are excellent and strong. Because of the investments, you find that there are lots of Indian nationals here. We have more than 7,000 Indian nationals here in Ethiopia. We have a number of professors in all universities in Ethiopia. We expect about 1,500 to 2,000 Indian professors and lecturers. Besides that, we have Indian investors in all fields. Most of them are in manufacturing, followed by agriculture. But in every corner of Ethiopia, you will find Indian investors. So because of this, because of the opportunities, because of the sound economic policy implemented by Ethiopia throughout the years, we find that Indian investors are increasing day by day. And because of this, the numbers of Indian nationals here in Ethiopia are increasing. And because they are large, we also have to look after their welfare. So I would like to take this opportunity to convey to my fellow Indian sisters and brothers, my fellow citizens, that the Indian embassy is here for you. We will attend to all your needs and requirements. If need be, we will even open our embassy beyond office hours. That is the assurance I would like to give to our Indian citizens here.
Wow, that's a great thing. I'm so happy. So guys, did you hear him? What did he say? That you can always come to Ethiopia and the embassy is always welcoming to the Indian fellow mates. That's nice. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right now, I'm at the lawn. I'm at the garden. And this is how the house looks. Isn't that beautiful? Hey guys, so today I am privileged that I am at IWA function. IWA is Indian Women's Association and it has monthly one program for the women who lives in Ethiopia, Addis Ababa. So I'm so excited to show you what IWA is. Let's go inside.
Hello everyone, myself Dr. Teji Sarna. I'm at IWA function here at Indian Embassy. So IWA stands for Indian Women's Association. It's an association of Indian women residing in Ethiopia. And this is a second home because whenever we meet, it's not that we are meeting in Africa. It looks like that we are in India. We are in India, enjoying India, Indian culture, meeting Indian friends, and best part is we talk a lot in Hindi. Only Hindi, Gujarati, Punjabi. So I love being a member of IWA. I'm a committee member. I'm a member since 3 years, 3 years plus. Everybody here is so warm. It doesn't feel that you are outside your country. So become a member soon.
I am Pallavi Mehta. I am the oldest member, probably 30 years or even more. I was one of the committee members. Even I used to organize events. So we enjoyed a lot in IWA and we had a good time in Addis Ababa. And we have a beautiful, beautiful Indian ladies in IWA. The talented ladies who gives a lot of knowledge and make life so living and pleasing in Addis Ababa.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching my vlog. Indeed, it was fun showing you around and showing you all the things that happen in Indian Embassy. There is IWA, there is Indian Business Forum, IBF. I am sorry not able to show you about IBF because of this virus. IBF has not conducted their events. But thank you so much for being part of my vlog. I appreciate each one of you. Signing off for now.